The first thing to keep in mind when you're dealing with Hadiths is they have to be authenticated. A lot of times people will cite, let's say, oh, this Hadith is in Sunan of Ibn Majah, or this Hadith is in the Sunan of Tirmidhi. Okay, up to a quarter of the Sunan of Ibn Majah is unreliable, according to great scholars like the 14th century scholar Al-Dhahabi. One-fourth of the book is unreliable. A book like Tirmidhi has lots of unreliable hadith in it because the author himself put those in there because he wanted to show you, this is what certain people think the Prophet said, but I don't think this is accurate. So it's not just a book of hadith he thinks are accurate, it's a book that collects also hadith he thinks are not accurate. So when someone cites a hadith from Tirmidhi, they might actually be citing something that Tirmidhi's putting in there that he doesn't even think is reliable. So don't just get lulled into this idea, he said this, someone so-and-so mentioned this book and he said it's in such and such a collection, or this hadith and it's such and such a collection. That's not a solution. Every hadith you come across has to be authenticated. Now there's certain hadith, let's say, that are in the Sahihain of Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Those are, vast majority of those have been considered authentic by Muslim scholars. But that's only two books out of lots of different hadith. Lots of the hadiths that we come across are not from the books of Bukhari and Muslim. Very important to keep that in mind. So hadiths have to be authenticated.